Bible said that the Lord himself shall descend with the voice, the sound of an archangel. So the church Pentecostal was born with the shout. The church Pentecostal will be living this world with the shout. Between the first shout and the last shout, there will be many shouts.
The sign.
sacrifice is given birth to. Not every lamb is fit for sacrifice. Not every lamb. A lamb that is fit for sacrifice is an unblemished lamb. A lamb that has no blemish at all. So it is very rare to find such lamb that doesn't have any blemish. So as soon as the lamb comes out, there will be a shout that this lamb is special, is for sacrifice. They will have to quickly get a sweeping cloth and wrap that lamb quickly so that the lamb will not be blemished, the lamb will not be injured, according to Leviticus chapter 22, and the lamb will be kept as a special lamb for sacrifice. And Jesus, God said unto the angel said unto the shepherds, he said, you will find a sign, a lamb, a child that is wrapped in a swaddling cloth. And immediately the shepherd will understand what the angels were saying. In Genesis chapter 22, the Bible says that God gave Abraham an assignment. He gave him a test. He told him, he said, you have to sacrifice your only son. When God called him, God had to call him and say, Abraham. And Abraham is used to God calling him. Abraham was expecting a prophetic thing or something good. But God said, you have to sacrifice your son, Isaac. And so he took Isaac. And when eventually the Bible says that they got to the place where the mountain where they were going to sacrifice, Isaac asked a question. The Bible said in verse 7, Isaac spake unto Abraham his father, Genesis 22, verse 7, and he said, my father, and he said, yeah, I have some. And he said, behold the fire, behold the wood, where is the lamb? And that question, people of God, is not a question that Isaac answered. It is an inspiration of God, because the answer of that question was not provided by Abraham. Because the Abraham said in verse 8, my son, God will provide himself a lamb. So it means Isaac was inspired of God to ask a question that is beyond his age. And Abraham was inspired by God to give an answer that is beyond his generation. He said, the Lord himself will provide. Abraham knew who the sacrifice is, isn't it? And I can tell you, Isaac also knew. But Isaac still asked the question. And the period, over 400 years, over generations, and over chapters of the Bible, that question was not answered until John chapter 1. The Bible says in verse 29, John chapter 1 verse 29, there was a forerunner called John the Baptist. He was there, and the next day, see Jesus coming unto him, and said, behold, the Lamb of God. I want you to know something here, because in Genesis chapter 22, hallelujah, the Bible said God will provide himself a lamb. And immediately the angel of the Lord said unto Abraham, 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 don't kill that child. Hallelujah. Genesis 22. He said, don't lay hands on that child. In verse 13, Genesis 22, verse 13. And the Bible said, don't lay hands on that child. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and beyond behind him there was. Is he a lamb? What was it? He was a lamb. So that was not the answer to the question. The answer to the question was in John, behold the Lamb of God. May I announce to you this evening, ladies and gentlemen, that Jesus did not only come as a king, he came as a sacrificial lamb. He came so that he can take away our sin. That's why he was born. Listen, people of God, sometimes we blame the innkeeper. They say, no, there was no room for him. Somebody said, if the innkeeper had known that Jesus would be born and he was going to be a king, he would have allowed them to put him in the manger and in the inn. But the innkeeper would not have allowed them, because the prophecy of the Bible was coming pass. Jesus must be born as a lamb. He has to be born in a manger. He has to be revealed to shepherds. He has to be covered with the swinging cloths. He has to be the sacrificial lamb of the world. The scriptures must be fulfilled. So he was not born in the inn because he was not supposed to be born in the inn. It was not the fault of the innkeeper that there was no room. God made sure there was no room. May I announce to you, wherever you ought to be, God will make sure you get there. The scripture will be fulfilled in your life. And that scripture will be fulfilled. said that the Bible says in John the Baptist, in John chapter 1, he said, behold the virgin in verse 29, this is he of whom I said, after me cometh the man which is preferred before me, for he was born before me. And the Bible says in 35, verse 35, he said, the next day, after John's two of John's disciples were there, and the Bible said, and looking upon Jesus as he was, he said, again, confirming, he said, behold, the Lamb of God. And the two disciples, they left John and they followed Jesus. If it were you, would you not follow Jesus? They've been thinking this man is a man. Then the man pointed to say, this is the Lamb of God. So they got sheep, hallelujah, they began, and they began to follow Jesus. I want you to know, people of God, that you must follow Jesus. It's important that the reason for this season is Christ. John the Baptist was a baptizer. You know, after John had died, there were some disciples that were seeing the life of the apostle, and they were preaching Jesus. They never heard of Jesus. He said, which baptism were you baptized? They said, the baptism of John. John has preached in such a way, he affected his generation, but it was not the real thing. The real thing is Jesus. I prophesy to your life this evening that everything that is required of you, Jesus will give you in the name of Jesus. That's why I want you to know, people of God, every time people ask you questions, I don't like the answer that people give. When someone asks you, are you married? Some people say no. Do you have a car? They say no. Do you have a house? They say no. No, don't say no, because no is a permanent answer to a temporary situation. When they ask you, do you have a car? What do you say? Not yet. Because very soon you will have one. Why? Because you are following Jesus. As a follower of Jesus, the Lord will provide all your needs in Jesus' name. Lift your hand, your hands are beginning to bless him. Worship him and thank him because you know who he is. He's the Lamb of God that come to take away the sin of the world. He came so that he can be sacrificed himself, so that you will not be a sacrifice. He came so that you will be indeed a blessing of the Lord. He will release by the sacrifice, by the